hear the words of the psalmist. I will tell the decree of the Lord. He said to me, you are my son. Today I have begotten you. Ask of me, and I will make the nations your heritage and the ends of the earth your possession. Blessed are you, O God, a maker and ruler of all things. Your voice thundered over the waters at creation. You water the mountains and send springs into the valleys to refresh and satisfy all living things. Through the waters of the flood, you carried those in the ark to safety. Through the sea, you led your people Israel from slavery to freedom. In the wilderness, you nourished them with water from the rock, and you brought them across the River Jordan to the Promised Land. By the baptism of his death and resurrection, your son Jesus has carried us to safety and freedom. The flood shall not overwhelm us, and the deep shall not swallow us up, for Christ has brought us over to the land of promise. He sends us to make disciples, baptizing in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Pour out your Holy Spirit, wash away the sin in this cleansing water, clothed and baptized with Christ. Claim your daughters and sons, no longer slave, but free, no longer male and female, but one with all the baptized in Christ Jesus. May we who have passed through the water of baptism continue in the risen life of our Savior. Amen. And let us pray. Righteous God, you sent your son Jesus to be baptized by John in the Jordan, so that all might hear the proclamation of your love. Make us voices of proclamation, so that all might know of your love through our words and our actions. We pray these things in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. We gather as the people of God to offer our repentance and praise, to pray for the unity of the church and the renewal of our common life. Trusting in God's mercy and compassion, let us ask for the forgiveness of our sins. Lord Jesus, you came to reconcile us to one another and to the Father. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you heal the wounds of pride and intolerance. Christ, have mercy on us. Christ, have mercy on us. Lord Jesus, you pardon the sinner and welcome the repentant. Lord, have mercy on us. Lord, have mercy on us. May Almighty God grant us pardon and peace, strengthen us in faith, and make us witnesses to Christ's love. Amen. Hear the good news. God did not send the Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through him. Those who believe in him are not condemned. In Jesus Christ, you are forgiven. Amen. Matthew tells us, in those days, John the Baptist came out preaching in the wilderness, out of Judea, and saying, repent, for the kingdom of heaven has come near. For these were the words that were spoken to the prophet Isaiah. A voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord, make straight paths for him. Now John's clothing were made of camel's hair. He wore a leather belt around his waist, and for food he ate locust and wild honey. And people came out from Jerusalem, all Judea, and all the regions surrounding the Jordan. They were confessing their sins and being baptized in the Jordan by John. When John looked and he saw many of the Pharisees and Sadducees had come out, he cried out to them, "You brood of vipers, you, who warned you of the wrath to come? Produce fruit that is keeping with repentance. Don't come out here and say that we are children of Father Abraham. I tell you that these stones God can raise up to be children of Abraham. Be ready, for the axe is already at the root of the tree, and every tree that does not produce good fruit will be cut down and thrown into the fire. I baptize you with water for repentance, but the one who comes after me, far more powerful than I am, his sandals I'm not even unworthy to bend down and untie. When he comes, he will baptize you with the fire of the Holy Spirit. His winnowing fork is in his hand. He'll clear the threshing floor, gather up the wheat, and the chaff he'll throw into the fire." Jesus came out to the from Galilee, out to the Jordan, to be baptized by John. When John saw that it was Jesus, he tried to stop him, saying, "I am the one who need be baptized by you." But Jesus replied, "Let it be so now, so that it is proper for us to do this, to fulfill all righteousness." So John baptized Jesus. And as Jesus was being baptized, he went up out of the water. That moment, the heavens opened, and the Spirit of God descended like a dove and alighted upon Jesus. And the voice from heaven cried out, "This is my Son, whom I love. I am well pleased with him." Amen. Hey, John the Baptist here. Everybody gets all hung up by the fact I'm out here in the wilderness, and people get, you know, all crazy about what I'm dressed like. And that's the problem, and what I'm trying to tell people about. Like, it's not, you know, how you look on the outside. You know, it's what's inside you. So I'm trying to tell people, because that's what God really cares about. What's inside you. You know, that you're good to people, and that you love God, and you love other people, and you take care of each other. And I'm trying to get him out of this wilderness and into the love of God. So, you know, I'm inviting him, come on down to the river to be baptized. You know baptism, right? It's what, you know, cleans the inside of us. And when I'm talking about, you know, like clean and dirty, I'm not talking about, like, you know, when our hands get all dirty with mud and we need to get ourselves some soap and water and clean up. Yeah. I'm talking about, like, the inside of us. Like, when we do mean things, like call people hurtful names, like, you know, they're stupid, or they're fat, or they're ugly, or we won't play with them and we won't share things with them. We're mean, and that makes us ugly inside. And how do you get that clean? It's the water's here. Well, it's not really the water, it's God. And, you know, God sends his love. Love Jesus, who I got to meet, and he shares that love and makes us better inside. I got something here for you. Don't go anywhere. Okay, so a little visual help here. So this is what, you know, this is you. Yeah, kind of nice and clean and pretty good person. And this here, ooh, this is all like the sin, the ugly colors. You know, when we're mean to people, we don't share, we're not polite, we lie and cheat and things like that. And you know what happens? It gets into our lives. And we start looking ugly too, don't we? Not a pretty color. But you see, God comes along in baptism, and God, well, he comes into our lives and he changes us. Whoa. We go from being that ugly color to something kind of pretty. God makes us better inside. He washes away the ugly stuff and gives us something good. So that's why Jesus got baptized, because he wanted us to get baptized and know that God washes us, chases away the bad things.
Will you join me in a word of prayer? Dear God, we thank you that you send your love through Jesus. We thank you for baptism that makes us clean inside. And we ask that you help us to share that love of Jesus with everyone. Amen. Alrighty, I gotta go back to the water here because I got some work to do. And see what happens? Even you get nice and clean on the inside. Happy baptism day.
My dentist's office, they have a poster hanging on the wall that while you're in the chair, you can look at and read. Funny little sayings from kids, you know, and has their, you know, name and age. One of the ones that I always chuckle at every time I see it is 6-year-old Connor telling you, never try to baptize a cat. Yeah, I think by the time we're all 7, we understand. Never try to baptize a cat. It just isn't gonna work or go well. And we understand why. Cats just aren't really, you know, into baptism much. Or water for that much. We understand, you know, what baptism is for and about. It's for us. It's about cleansing us, washing our sins, and making us child of God. So this morning, when we hear of John the Baptist's hesitation when Jesus comes out and saying, no, no, I can't baptize you. You apparently don't understand Jesus. Let me explain baptism. So baptism is for God's people who are sinful, which is all of us. And we come out here, we recognize that we're sinners, and then we need God to forgive us. We need God in our lives. So the water is poured on us, God's Spirit cleanses us of our sin, and God makes us his child. Jesus, you don't need this. See, you have no sin. You are pure of spirit. And guess what? You are the child of God. So you don't need this baptism. But Jesus insists and persists until pretty much makes John baptize him. But why? Why does Jesus, Son of God, pure and blameless, need baptism? A little bit later in Matthew's gospel. In fact, move on to the next verse, because right after he's baptized, right after the heavens open and declare, this is my son, my beloved, God's Spirit leads Jesus into the wilderness to be tempted by the devil. I have a play about that, and it's a 6-act play breaking down the temptations. And the opening one, when the devil and Jesus first meet each other and they're trying to figure out who they are. There's the scene where, you know, Jesus is talking about how hungry he is because he's been out there fasting for 40 days and 40 nights and he's just starving. And the devil says, oh, this is going to be so easy. He picks up a rock and hands it to him and said, here, eat this. You can't do that. I'll break a tooth. It's a rock. Oh, no, 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 no. It's not a rock. Not for you. It's whatever you want it to be. Filet mignon? Lobster? Too complicated? How about something simple? Bread. Nice, warm, crusty loaf of mom's baked bread? Nope, can't do that. And the devil looks and says, you, the Son of God, can't turn this rock into a loaf of bread? Oh, if you mean, do I have the ability to do that? Oh, yes, I can do that. But do I have the will to do that? I don't. And the devil further asks, what do you mean you don't have the will to do that? Like, because And Jesus gestures around all of God's children. They can't do that. Not one of them. Not one of them, when they're hungry, can pick up a rock and say, "Bread," and eat. Not one of them that's cold can say, "Warmth," and the sun shines brighter for them. Not one of them can do any of those kinds of things that I can do. And I'm here to bring God's love and to show them that God understands. God knows them and loves them. So I'm going to do the things they can do and live the way they can, so they can see that God's Son brings his love to them. And John looks at Jesus saying, "You don't need to be baptized." "Well, I need to be baptized. I truly need to. You, everyone needs to see me in their lives, every day, always, a part of you, no matter what's going on. Because, dear John the Baptist, dear brothers and sisters in Christ, when you weep, Jesus weeps. When you laugh, Jesus laughs. For Jesus is with us through all things, all times, always with us. Amen. Sisters and brothers, our baptismal vows call us to compassion and mercy on behalf of those in need. We offer our prayers for the church and the world. We pray that your Spirit rest upon the church and its leaders, that we may better proclaim to your great love and mercy. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray that your Spirit rest upon the waters, that this fundamental element of life be protected and preserved for all people. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray that your Spirit rests upon the president, senators, representatives, governors, mayors, and all civil leaders, that they may serve with compassion and humility. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray that your Spirit rest upon all the baptized, that they may live in ways that please you. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray that your Spirit rest upon those dealing with illness and loss, that they may know the peace of your presence with them always. We especially pray for those most near and dear to us in our hearts. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray that your Spirit rest upon this assembly, that we may prepare the way for the coming of your kingdom. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray that your Spirit rest upon the faithful dead, that their memory may strengthen our faith and move us to acts of love and charity. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord God, you revealed your Son in the waters of the Jordan and anointed him with the power of the Holy Spirit to proclaim good news to all people. Sanctify us by the same Spirit, that we may proclaim the healing power of the gospel of acts of love in your name. Amen.
You shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety.
Blessed are you, O Lord God. You are life and light of all. By your powerful word, you created all things. Through the prophets, you called your people to be a light to the nations. Blessed are you for Jesus, your Son. He is your light, shining in our darkness and revealing us to your mercy and might. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering, therefore, his preaching and healing, his dying and rising, and his promise to come again, we await that day when all the universe will rejoice in your holy and life-giving light. By your Spirit, bless us in this meal, that refreshed with the heavenly food, we might be light for the world, revealing the brilliance of your Son. Through him, all honor and glory and might is yours, Almighty Father, the Holy Spirit in your Holy Church, both now and forever. Amen. The body of Christ given for you. The blood of Christ shed for you. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. Go now as the light of the nations. Honor the Lord. Tell what you know of the risen Christ and fulfill all righteousness. And may God strengthen you and bless you with peace. May Christ Jesus bring forth justice for you and among you. And may the Holy Spirit alight on you and affirm you as God's beloved ones. Amen. Amen. Go in peace. Be the light of Christ. Lord, now you let your servant go in peace. Your word has been fulfilled. My own eyes have seen the salvation which you prepared in the sight of every people, a light to reveal you to the nations and the glory of your people Israel. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.